welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. We've got one, a new one to me, from the Tollycobbold Breweries. It's Tollycobbold. Got the bee, one of the bees back the front, a bit like ABBA and all that, you know. The Tollycobbold Brewery. Now, it gets its name from Tom Marsh and Cobbold family brewers got together to make the Tollycobbold Brewery. That kind of at one point collapsed down in that like house of cards, and now it's come back up again. So they've kind of reintroduced it, Tollycobbold, with the beer The Phoenix. It's 4.2% ABV. And we're going to see how we go with that. What does it say? Brewing Perfection on the bottle. On them, that nice dipply little stuff that they have on the bottles. Out with an S-Car again. And we're going to see how we go. Plain gold cap on there. Which ain't too bad, you know. You never know with them. Depends on the brewers, I suppose. Right, in we go. I'm going to have a sniff in the bottle. Not a lot. Let's pour it and see. Pour it out and see how we go. It's coming out quite kind of what I describe as wheaty. It's kind of coming out a bit thick, a bit rich and slow. And it's, looks like it's holding that head. So it's probably wheat or something in there. There's a carbonation going on. I'll tip it that way, you can just see that going on there. That's quite nice. Lovely dark colour. Should hold me a bit of paper up in this light. But there is the dark colour, like a Coca-Cola. And I'll drink that stuff. Anyway, let's have a sniff. Oh, smells nice. In the bottle, you ain't getting nothing. But off the nose, you're getting licorice-y smells. You're getting licorice smells. What's they say there? Fruit you're getting, yeah, it says biscuit malt. Yeah, definitely. You're getting licorice, you're getting the fruit in there, you're getting fruit nose. It's really sweet and lovely smelling. It smells almost kind of like a sherbet-y sort of smell, but with fruit in there with it. Kind of like cherries, raspberries, those sort of things. Yes, that's as you can see, it's holding on there as well. And at where are we? 4.2. That must be the oils in there holding that up. That's not kind of alcohol legs. That's the oils holding that like that. You can see them stretch out. Watch. See them stretch like a bubble. Bubbles have got kind of the similar sort of thing. They stretch, but the proteins in them stretch out and kind of, you know, it's hard to explain, but it's out of molecules and everything, but it kind of stretches out, you know, with the weight of that. Right, I'm going to dive in. Oh, that's nice. That is really nice. That's lovely. Hey, it's really, really lovely. Oh, it's another Green King. Brewed by Green King Barry St. Edmunds. It's all that cobblers about collywobble and everything else. I feel a little bit cheated. It's me reading all the thing about the, you know, doing my own work and reading. I'm not getting mad. But I feel a bit fucked about, sorry. you do your own work, you read this thing on here, you know, sometimes you even look up on the internet and everything else, and you go, oh, resurrection of the Tully Cobble name and everything, war and all that, and the Tully Marsh and the thing. And there's me going, yeah, spouting on. All the time it's Green King. Now, I love Green King, they do a great job. And as you can see, they do a great job. But I'm a bit pissed off with that, because you do your own work. And then down there in little tiny writing says, brewed by Green King. Why are they kind of, they're not embarrassed about that, surely? It's a lovely drink. Just put Green King on it. Green King's good. They're a good brewer. They do Moreland, they do this. They do their own Green King stuff. Alright, the plain Green King IPA ain't up to much. The export's not bad, it's pretty good. They're very special. Ooh, wow. Anyway. We're on this. I'm not ranting, because it's a lovely drink, and I'm actually enjoying a lovely drink. So let's get some more of it. God, it really is good. Really is lovely. You're getting a little bit of clove in there. You're getting a tiny kind of smokiness almost. You're getting, this is going to sound really strange, it really will sound strange, but you're getting a kind of the not the salty sweat, but the kind of the stuff off of the bacon fat, when it's just starting to cool a little bit and you get them oils come off, a little bit of that, you won't know what I mean unless you try it, and then you'll go, oh yeah, just in the distance, it's almost, not a saltiness, but just that sort of note in there somewhere. That is a joy. That really is a joy. I would say go and buy that and try that, because that's a joy, that one. That is really nice. It's kind of it's got that Garibaldi sort of thing going on, you know, them Garibaldi biscuits. It's a bit like that. It's got the chewy fruit, it's got the biscuits, the kind of crunchy sort of crunchy biscuit thing, it's got a bit of caramel going on there. And the fruitiness, yeah. Well, that's a winner for me. Tully Cobbled Breweries. It's Green King Brewery. And that's a phoenix there, risen from the flame, squashed down and risen again under the squashed down and risen again under the Green King, the Green King kind of umbrella. And I don't know why they kind of couldn't just say put Green King on it or something. I don't know. Maybe that's just me being fussy, because loads of different bottles and brewers do that sort of thing. You know, there's loads of them do it. So it's all good, you know. It's just, you feel like such a fool sometimes that you've gone and done your own work instead of just jumping in there blindfolded. And you've done a bit of your own work and been made to look a bit banana, you know. But there you go. Anyway, chin chin, beautiful stuff. Green King, you've done it again. Fantastic. You've done it again. Let's see some ingredients on them. Let's see maybe whoever the brewer is, whether it's InBev, Green King, or whoever, or Joe down the road in his bedroom. Let's see, a little bit bigger than that, a little bit bigger maybe, so we can go, oh no, it's brewed by a shepherd named Green King or whoever, you know. So, let's see a bit bigger, yeah. Let's put some ingredients on there as well, you know, so we know what's going on. That would be nice. Anyway, chin chin, bottoms up, cheers. Oh, I like that. I like that. That's nice. Go buy it and try it. It's in Tesco at the moment.